Hi, I am Michael, a senior web developer, and today we will be looking at Vue 3, the composition API, so setup, refs, and all of this we will need to build a button for our component framework. So let's start. So here I have the project from last time. This is our playground. Let's first have a look how it looks right now. So this is how it looks right now. This is actually a button, as you can see, but yeah, it looks ugly, it has nothing in it, and yeah, we need to style it and create it, right? So if you remember, we have our button here already created in our index view. You can see here's our implementation. But first things first, we first need to add, or we want to have typography, right, for the whole thing, like for whole project. So the thing which we need is basically a typography variable stuff export which we can use. So let's first create a folder here which is called typography, right? And as we had last time, here we will create two files. First the variables scss and the exports scss, right? So nothing new here. And for now, we will just need a few of them. So basically, let me just copy this over here. So we have one font for the headings, one font for the primary, one secondary font, and a base size, right? So this is usually your standard setup for bigger pages where you have like three, two, and in some cases just one font, right? But this is more like a This is more like a backup font here. Mainly we will use these two here, right? For our button, we will use the primary font and the base size. So we now have our variables done, right? So these are our typical SCSS variables. And now we need to export them, right, into both a CSS module and into like your normal root exports to use them as a CSS variable. So as last time, again, if we look here, it's the same. So basically what we can do is exactly the same. Let me copy it because again, this is boring to type out. Nothing special here, actually. So again, here we are making them, let me just close it so it's not complaining. So here we are having basically just a mapping to making them CSS variables, standard CSS variables. And here we have export for the CSS modules, right? Then we should not forget to import this thing here, right? So typography, export, boom. So now we have them here. And also, yeah, that's it. And we should not forget to add them here, right? So we also need to import them here. So again, typography. And again, the same export CSS thing here, typography here. And that's basically it for now. So now we have something we can use in our button as a like default font size and default font to use. So let's start. Now we have this done, right? We can now think about first checking why our compiler failed. So yeah, one thing we need to do, and I forgot to do this because it's still weird, but this is how it works. We need to basically define as what we are importing this here, if we import more than one use, right? So this is just SCSS, typography, and now it's compiling and everything should be fine. So yeah, every time we use this like that, we need to basically say what it is. That's it, there is nothing more. And maybe one last thing, if we have a theme, right? So if we have any theme where we want to do stuff, let's maybe add a font size, which we have defined here, right? So we know that it's our text base size, right? So now we have a base size set for the body and for our theme everywhere. So that's cool. And let's maybe also set the font family here, so we are, so we make sure that it's the correct one everywhere, at least, yeah, we, again, where we are using our thing here. So yeah, that's basically now like a very, very basic setup for fonts. And we can now go to our button to start implementing it. So basically, what we need to do here is to just write a Vue component, which is a normal button, right? So nothing too fancy here. So again, we have started already with this here. So we will also use some styling. So what we can do here is, again, we will use style lang as CSS. And we need to close it, of course, right? So we have it now here. But now we can do LCS button for our button and complaining because there is nothing. So content should be sorry, cursor. Cursor should be pointer. Just to make sure that every browser does it correctly. Whew. And so also we want the text to be in the center and buttons usually. So again, now comes in the font size. The font size should be, of course, now our font base size, right? And to make the line line height, like to make the button look correct, the line height should be also of a size of a base, like the font size of our base size. Then, of course, usually buttons are like a call to action for something. So let's make it font width 400. Again, nothing fancy here, and the border style of solid. But yeah, maybe we can have a first look at our button. So we can see the it's changed the font. But that's it for now, nothing more, right? Let's maybe put this, like, what I would like to do is have like this different areas in the CSS where I can see what stuff is. So here is all the border stuff. So it's later easier to find or like see where something logically, like the border ends and starts. So again, we want to add some padding, of course, to our button. So we have 10 pixels and 40 pixels. And what I usually like in buttons, because again, we want to have something which is for the user to click on, and it should be like visible. Oops, no, it should be text transform to uppercase if we forget it. So it's always uppercase. And yeah, that's basically the thing for now. And we will change this later, but for now, I will just say it here so we can have a look at the button. First of all, we need a color, and again, the color should be our text color. And we also need a border color here, right? And the border color in our button should be the same. Oops, what have I done? This is wrong. Okay, so of course it needs to look like this. Let's see if it's still compiling. It's compiling, cool. So let's have a look how our button looks right now. Didn't change too much. The question is why. So yeah, we have a typo here. This should be a big B Or let's maybe change it here to a small b because yeah, this looks better. Here it should be of course big. Yes, it's small. If we now go to our thing, we can see, boom, there we have a button which looks a little bit like we wanted it. But yeah, that's just the basic styling. Right now, we want to have different types of buttons, right? So basically, the type determines how the button looks. And also, we will do two things, right? Two props we can put into the button. So there are like two configuration steps to the button we can do. One of them should be the type of the button. So one prop will be type. The type is string. And require and the default, sorry, not required, the default value should be primary. And the second prop we want to do is block. Block basically means that it should span all of the whole space it can. So either it's true or false, and by default our button doesn't span too much. We need to add a comma here. And we, since this type is a string, we want to validate the validator, right, on it, basically to validate if the string we want is the actual string. So there is a validator function for each prop where you pass in the value. Our value in this case is a string. This is for TypeScript. And what do we want? We now want to define a way of, hey, look, only this type of buttons are allowed, right? What we want to have is, of course, primary, because we already know that primary is there. So what's a good fit for this is, for example, an array, which is like a list for our thing. And we will have three types of buttons. We have primary, plain, and full, which is maybe not the best name, but yeah, for now, it's okay. And we are using the function for arrays called includes value. So basically what this does now, we pass in the value here. And this includes will return true or false if this value is inside of here, right? So primary, plain, or full. This will return, one of them will return true. If not, it will return false. So yeah, this is basically how you can have a string validator. And for the block, we don't need basically any validation because we will not use block equals true or equals false. We'll just write block into it, right? So let's maybe go to the playground and let's define our buttons, right? So the thing is, by default, we have primary on it. So this button, so this here is should look exactly the same as type primary, right? It doesn't have to be any value. It's just like this. So yeah, we now should see two buttons and they are looking the same. Then we also would all have a third variant of it, which is a block, right? So we want to also have a block. Yeah, so again, this is why you don't need to, like, you can do, of course, validation if it's a Boolean, but yeah, you're already saying it's a Boolean, so you don't need to actually validate because it can only be true or false. So this is the same as writing the following, right? Oops, block, blah, true, right? So it's the same, but yeah. Everybody also from React knows that this means basically the same as true. Why are you complaining here? Yeah, sometimes VS Code is not so smart. So then we will have also two other buttons, which are basically our full and our plain. And of course, and also can be block and not block, but for the sake of just looking at them, this should be enough. So if we now go here, we can see all of them look the same, right? And this is not what we want. We want, of course, to look so they look different, right? So the first thing we need to do is basically we need to come here. And what you can do in Vue is have both class and like the compute, like the interpreted class, right? So this is like fixed, and this is whatever you put into type will be added as a class. Right, so this is the first part. Now we will have LCS button primary as a class, right? If we maybe go here, it should already work. We can see LCS button. I don't know if you can read this. Like we can see your LCS button and primary. Right, here is it full and plain. And now we want to do the block thing, right? So there are different ways of doing it. For the sake of presentation, I will do it the following way, because you will learn something. If it's the best way, I'm not sure, but basically just this is how we can do it. So what we want to do is basically once we pass block in, we need to style it as a block, as a button which spans, right? So just to learn about refs and stuff like this, we will now do it the following. So display will be display. And the second thing was with make it 100% will be with. It's the, so now it's complaining here that it cannot find something, doesn't really matter. So what's your problem here? Unexpected, no parsing error. What? Oh, I forgot the. I forgot this one. Thanks. Yeah. So now it's okay. Come on. Now it's okay. Also, I would like to have it a little bit more organized, like this. Looks to me better. And of course, this should be like this since this is computed. And yeah, like this looks good. We of course should at some point install some linting. I mean, you can also style it like this. Doesn't really matter. So we have a class here. We have a type and everything. Now let's fill this with life. So the first thing, which is new in Vue 3, is the setup thing, right? So this is basically like your entry point into your Vue component. This will run every time a component is created. And in other cases also. So after every render, basically, if you are coming from React functional components, then this is exactly the same. But we're not having hooks here and stuff like this. We are having for like reactive variables, we have ref, which is kind of confusing because we have refs and HTML part of Vue, and now we have ref, but ref is basically a variable which is reactive. And we will of course now need to have two of them, right? One ref is the display thing because we are using it on top in our style thing. And I hope it guessed it correctly. So basically we have now ref here. Thank you VS Code for guessing correctly. And we have let with, which is also equals ref, and unset to make sure that nothing else has set the width, right? Because we want to force it to be a block, whatever we put into it. No, please make it like a block thing, right? So this is what we are doing here. And now a little bit of TypeScript type notation. So what we can do is have ref, which again needs to be imported. And what we are giving back is of course a string, right? So what this basically means, that this ref type is actually like, I mean, I'm oversimplifying it, but we have a type of ref, which is a string, right? So this is how you can read this. I can see like here value, because what we are saying, hey, we have a ref. Now I guess it's a string, and yeah. If I do this, it will now complain that, yeah, like display declared, well, it's never used. That doesn't matter. But the type ref string is not assignable to type ref number, right? So we are basically here saying, look, whatever is inside of here should be a string. So that's it. Basically, it's not JavaScript, it's TypeScript. That doesn't have nothing to do with Vue. It's just nicer to now understand. So the next thing maybe is, how does Vue know to use this, right? If we do it like this right now, it will not work. What we need to do is to make it available in the template. We need to return these values as an object. And basically we just need to specify them like this. But now they are available in our code, right? So if we look at the component, we can see like display inline block and width is unset. Cool. And now we need to basically check our props, right? We now want to see, hey, is a prop block set, yes or no? And with the setup thing, the first argument are the props. So this is basically the, you can add the props. And now we are just getting the block. And now again comes a part with refs, right? So what you think with normal, you would do like this, right? If display ref is like block is true, then we can set display immediately to block. This doesn't work because this doesn't work like this. If you come here, like you can see type string is not assignable to type ref string, right? This error doesn't help you much with a thing, but again, thanks to TypeScript, we at least know that we are doing something wrong. What we need to do here is basically type value, and now we are setting a new value to it. This is how basically it works. So this is how proxies and stuff work in JavaScript. Well, we can talk about this another time, but for now, you need to know if you're using refs, give a ref a new value, we basically need to use value here, right? And with if we will do the same, making it 100%. So now it's compiling. Like we can see, boom, our one button is now a block, right? So it's stretching out. That's cool. Let's maybe just also do one thing to make it easier understandable what this is. This is a default. This is primary. This is, primary block. This is full. And this is plain. And so if we now go here, we can see, okay, this is correct. Default, nothing happens. But yeah, we didn't also break any or don't have any strange behaviors. So now we know that everything is fine. And yeah, that's basically it for the Vue part of it, right? So we have now a validation here. We now cannot put in something strange. What we also have is now the block thing ready. And now we can start the style stuff, right? So we know that we have our button and we have our three types, right? So we have primary. We have LCS button full, and we have LCS button plain. So we have these three types of buttons we can now style as we want to. And I already told you that we need to change this here, right? Because these are the colors we want to use just for our primary button. But again, it will always be applied because this is the default value. So it's kind of as the same as it would be here. if we don't, let me just fix a typo, if we don't put this up here, right? So we can remove this. So now this will be only here. And also one thing for the primary button is that the background of this button, at least this is what I have in mind, because again, it's what I want to do with this primary button, is it should always have the background of what's behind it, right? So we are setting it to transparent. Again, just the stylistic choice, has nothing to do. The next thing we now want to do is also have a hover state, right? So what we can do is primary and then do hover. And what we want to do for hover is now basically like do a little bit of inverting of it, right? So we have named the color to text color. This will stay the same. So let's write it out. So the color will be var text color. The border color will be the color of also text color. And then the background color will be the accent color, right? So if we now go to our page and we hover over the primary buttons, we can see that it's changing the thing, but this doesn't look too nice. So let's add a transition to them. So let's add transition, let's make it for all the things. Let's make it 2.3 seconds and ease out is what I find looks nice. Again, you can change these values, right? You can do animations on whatever you want. But yeah, like this is it, right? So now we have this smooth button, which we hover over it. And yeah, it basically like looks nice already. And yeah, so now we have our first button and it's now super easy to style the rest of it, right? So we are basically now repeating just this process here for all the buttons, as long as we are like happy with what, like once we have it, we have three buttons. And you can see how this is extendable. If you want to have more of them, you just add more types and more styles. You could probably also do this with Vue, but again, with this method, we can also change it in the themes easier. And yeah, this is something we'll do next time. There we will create our default theme with two themes, and then like magic, we will see that we don't need to touch this code anymore to have theme support. We actually have already theme support, but we will see how it works next time. So if you like the content, subscribe down below. Also to see the magic of theming stuff next time. So what we have here again, now we want it to be the background color, our default of our theme. The border color should be our text color in this case. And the background color should be our text color also. Right, so we can have a look. So here we see now it's like this. But you can see that the hover stuff is not working because we didn't define it. Let me just copy it, because yeah, this is kind of boring to watch it. So again, the color of a hover thing is still the same, but now if we hover, like you can see, this is how it looks. Again, you can change this to whatever you like. This is again just how I imagine it to be, right? If you hover it, look and see, like boom, it's like this. But for example, it's super easy now to change to text color. So if we hover it, it looks like this. Or like even here we can change it to look. Oops, that was the wrong one. Like the color should be maybe text color, right? So it's just like this. Again, whatever floats your boat, we can leave it like this. But you can see how easy it is now to change how the button looks. And of course, you can see like this is not so hard on the eyes. And this is more like focus on your eyes. So you can see like if you want to really someone to click on something, you would use this full variant. And now let's create this plain button here. So basically the plain, I did it wrong, will have no hover state because it's plain. And what plain means basically, yeah, it's kind of the weakest thing to call to action, basically. So it's like, yeah, it's a button if you hover it, but actually we don't want the user to click on it, but still, if we need to have this option. So that's the idea behind this one. And basically, this is our styling for it. All right, so we can see now it's super plain. Let's maybe put it into a div. So, oh, this thing is now on a new line. You can see it's like there is nothing here. Let's add a right. So yeah, you can see it's like super plain. It's like almost integrated into it. If we now change it to click me, maybe you can see it's kind of, if you read it, you click on it, but yeah, otherwise you would not even think about it to clicking on it. So yeah, that's basically how we can customize our buttons. That's our button component for now. Again, like it's just like our first component, but I think the button is like the most used component in any framework and any website, since it's usually how you interact with a website. So yeah, we now have basically this around here, and these are like the most typical buttons usually you have. And yeah, that's basically it. Thank you for watching and see you next time. Bye.